This is a nice JCB teleskid. We've got a 270 John Deere skid steer, and I've always been curious about these JCBs. I've heard really good things about the teleskid, the safety aspects of it, the functionality of it, so I'm excited to give this thing a whirl. All right, everyone, we've got Chris from JCB, and we're going to go over the whole lowdown on this JCB teleskid. He's going to give us the functions and capabilities of this machine and train us how to run it so that we don't do anything stupid, because that does happen from time to time on this farm. With
him. Farm boys. Definitely farm boys.
Chris, where you're from Georgia, and that's where the headquarters is? Of.
Yep, I am from Savannah, Georgia. I am the product manager for skid steers and compact track loaders.
It's good to have you here. Let's go through this
All
thing.
Right.
Hi, Chris. Go ahead and tell us a little about this thing.
Okay, so what we have here is the JCB teleskid. It has a forward reach, as you can see, of 8 feet in height. Is 13 feet.
So that's 3,200 pounds, fully retracted, lift capacity, and then 1347. 1347 with the wheel version, fully extended.
It does have a 74 horsepower JCB EcoMax engine. You just fill it with diesel and off you go. Nice. One of the sayings that we have in our factory in Savannah, Georgia, is we call this the world's safest skid steer. And the reason being is because of the side door entry.
Can I fit?
Our cabs are actually 33% larger than our competitors' cabs. Okay, so Scott's gonna demonstrate our options. So seat belt. So we're gonna pull that down. Right lap bar comes across your lap. You can't adjust the seat back here. So if you wanna adjust it.
Nice.
Your left is your operational joystick. Your right is your boom. You have a hand throttle located right there on your right. Yep, so if you rotate that, it increases the RPM of the machine. And if you don't like that, you also have a foot throttle as well.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's sweet. That's a nice option. I like that.
Yep. Then you got this rocker switch to push down. It'll bring the teleskid in. Up, we'll extend it out.
All right, there we go. Thanks, Chris.
Not a problem.
Awesome. Thank you, JCB. We're excited to try this out. We got a lot of ideas ahead of us to put this through the paces and see how she handles. Sounds like it's going to be pretty good. Now, obviously, the first and foremost beauty of this machine is I was able to climb out of it with a load up in the air without being in danger, because I could step out this side. That's been around a while, but it's new to us, and that's pretty cool how that works. Well, right off the bat, I can tell you, this thing's touchy. I'm not used to how sensitive it is. Our skid steer, our John Deere, has so much slop in the controls. You gotta really move things to make stuff happen. It's just finger movement. Gotta get used to that. I know I've driven other machines that are like that. When you go from an old to a new, that difference is just normal. But I'm gonna have to learn it. There might be a way to adjust sensitivity. I'm gonna look into that too. But man, that's pretty cool. First job done. This could be a bad thing. We got leg arms in the teleskid. I didn't give him the keys to it. He found them, I guess. because this project was never really fully finished, and it was done literally a year ago as of like yesterday. I'm gonna go to town and I'm gonna get a load of sand from the old international dump truck here, because we're gonna use all that sand for fun. Let's go get a load. Because of that recent rain, we're not able to get in the field at all. It'll be soon, but I can't do any spraying and they can't do any hauling of grain till probably tomorrow, or maybe even as much as Thursday, because today is Tuesday. So it's a great time to do what I'm about to do. All right, gotta wait for them to come. They're gonna bring the loader over. I'm gonna give me some of that sand right there. All right, here we are. I am back where I need to be. If you haven't guessed already, I'm gonna finish the playground, because we never did. And it about blew over, it needs anchored, it needs sand. So this is what the sand's for. I got plans, let's put this playground together. And we've got a JCB teleskid to help us out, because why not? That is awesome. It's got features that are gonna make this nice. So what we gotta do first, we gotta move the whole playset back out of this spot, because we gotta get the sand in place and make the pad for it. So we're gonna try to move it in one piece. Leg arms is having way too much fun with this thing. Look at this. I haven't even started to get working hardly on this playset. That telescoping boom is awesome. Until we get a good use for these tires in this area, they're just gonna get piled. Unfortunately, that's what happens. They have to get buried or piled. And this is scab land. As you can see, not even sagebrush grows here. It's junk, rocky. It's just absolute clay. Okay, let's get out of here. Leg arms are already taken off. man. I was making good progress, and then the fuel alarm came on. Yeah, let's go get some fuel. On the bright side, this thing's got a 74 horsepower engine, which the benefit to that is that I can just put diesel in it and not worry about any urea. Cool. Well, we called it a day last night after we got all the stakes put down. My dad came out and helped, and we figured out exactly where to put the pipes to make a pretty close to accurate hexagon. I think it'll work out okay. End to end is about 30 feet. That's about what we need for the playset to clear these pipes. So I'm gonna start putting the pipe down, line it all up, and then start cutting the angles on the edges of the pipe so they butt together correctly. And then we can put sand in here, level it, put the playset on, finish last pipe, and go swinging. This thing's so fun. Leg arms to be careful cutting off the angle on every one of these pipes. We'll cut the top ones and lay it on the top first, then we'll go through and we'll cut the bottom ones. And then we'll find a way to join them together. Okay, got the cuts finished. Now we're gonna line everything up and see if it fits. It's a little uneven on the ground, so, but we're gonna try to maybe weld these together or rebar them down, we'll see. So, funny thing, we tried a 110 volt welder we had, thinking it might be enough to weld this pipe together, and it didn't do very good. So, we brought out the stick welder. I can hardly use this thing, very little. Pops is running it, he knows how to run it. We're gonna weld this thing together. We'll be right back.
Well, there. Plus one for the kids. And plus one for the teleskid. Worked out pretty slick.
We're gonna have it for a couple more weeks.
So, I'm sure we'll find more things to do with it. I've already got a bunch of stuff in mind. But so far, that was a pretty good experience running this thing. But anyways, guys, if you liked the video, make sure you like and subscribe. We just hit 200,000 subscribers, so that's pretty epic. So thank you all for being a part of this. Anyways, guys, take care, God bless, and stay tuned for the next video, because there's gonna be more, guaranteed.